One of the key enablers for making these 2.5D or 3D chips is this process technology called through silicon via, or more commonly abbreviated as TSVs. So these through silicon via, they essentially are critical because they allow this kind of 3D stacking of chips, and they are essentially what enables this chip to communicate with the chip above it and communicate with the chip below it, and they also bring in the power supply voltage and so on. So one of the most important thing to enable these 3D or 2.5D technology is this through silicon via. So let's look at the unit process which is involved for making this through silicon via or TSV. So these are the different process steps which are which you would have to encounter if you need to make a through silicon via. So the first thing that you need to do is to etch. So the first thing you need to do is etch this silicon, this trench into the silicon, which would act as your TSV, which would in which you'll fill up your TSV material. One of the critical features of this etch that is that it's very high aspect ratio. So typically this would be anywhere from 100 to 150 micron deep, and it would not be more than a few micrometer wide. So it would be, from 1 to 5 micrometer wide. You could have it more wider, but then what you'll compromise is your layout efficiency. So if you make it wider, you need a much larger area for each of your TSV, so you'll lose your area on your chip for making this TSV. So of course you don't want to do that, so you want to keep this TSV width small. At the same time, you need to keep it deep enough such that it enables you to connect etch through the entire depth of your wafer. So that essentially requires that now you have very high aspect ratio for this etch. So this aspect ratio for this etch would be anywhere from 20 to 100. And you want to maintain a uniform profile. So excuse my poor drawing skills here, where I have drawn it as good as it is, but still you want it, much better than it in your actual TSV. So you want your profile to be vertical as much as possible, and you want it to be uniform. So this etch is a very demanding etch. First of all, it's a high aspect ratio, and you also want to control your profile. The next step, which is after this, is deposition of an oxide. So this trench was etched into the silicon material. Silicon, as you know, is a semiconductor, and if we fill it with a metal, it would diffuse into your semiconductor. Also, your signal will now, get lost in your silicon chip. So you want to put an insulator in this trench. So you grow oxide in this trench. And since it's a very high aspect ratio trench, a challenge for growing this oxide is the step coverage. So you want the same thickness of your oxide on the top and you want the same thickness on the bottom. So you want a very good step coverage of this oxide growth. Also, another thing which is critical, especially if you are forming this vias towards the end of your process flow, is to keep the growth temperature of this oxide low so it does not affect the transistors which have already been made. And some of these vias will be actually, they'll be carrying, say, supply voltage or high voltages. So you want the breakdown voltage of this oxide to be low as well. The next process, which is after you fill it up with oxide, is and before you fill it up with a metal, is you want to put a barrier layer or a seed layer of metals. So this barrier layer will prevent the diffusion of the metal into your silicon, or diffusion of your metal into your oxide. Another thing important is the step coverage. So you want the same thickness of this metal on the top, and you want the same thickness on the side. And another important thing is that this metal that you're filling in is a good diffusion barrier. The next step you do after that is once you have a barrier and a seed, you plate it. So you could plate it with copper or tungsten, and an requirement for that plating is to make this fill void free, so make sure that, you know, there are no voids left when you plate it. Another very important thing is to minimize the stress during this plating. So it's so important, let me put in a box that this in fact is, you know, very important that when you're doing this fill, avoid the stress in this fill. And then the next step and the final step is you polish off these extra layer on the top. So you remove these, you polish it off, and you so you do a chemical mechanical polishing, and you then that's it, and then your, you know, your TSV is done. So to summarize, these are the different specifications for the different process steps. So you want a good etch profile. You want it to happen fast. Remember that, you know, we are etching through a very large depth. We are etching 200, 250 micron deep of silicon. So we don't want the wafer to wait all day for this etch to happen. So we want a fast etch. At the same time, we want it to be low cost. We want these vertical, nice, smooth sidewalls. And we want a good step coverage for our oxide. So we want the same thickness of your oxide on the sidewall. So we want a conformal and good deposition of this oxide layer. Again, you want a good metal and barrier fill, and you want to avoid stress. Remember, this is very important. So we want to minimize the stress during this whole process flow as much as we can.